Guys, how are you all? My name is Harshit Devedi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be discussing with you the Indian National Army trials. Actually, there were total 10 trials. The first trial was known as the Red Fort trial. So I'll be discussing with you, friends. In the first trial, three brave soldiers of our Indian National Army were being court-martialed. They were Gurbaksh Singh Dhillon, Major Shanawaz Khan and Prem Sahgal. These are the photos of those brave heroes, friends. So this is presented by me, friends. If you want to follow me, the link of my Instagram profile is given in the description box below, friends. Also, if you want to watch the Hindi version of the video, that is already uploaded on my YouTube channel, so friends. So that link you can also find in the description box below. So let's start with it, friends. What happened in it? See, these Indian National Army trials, actually it was a total number of 10 trials between November 1945 and May 1946. And during this trials, court-martial of a number of officers of Indian National Army were done. Various charges were being implied on them. The charges of treason, murder, torture and abetment to murder. Treason charges were there because these soldiers were previously the soldiers of the British Army. After that, they went to the side of Japan and Japan helped them to form the Army of Indian Independence, and they marched inside India to fight the British only. So the Britishers said that if you were initially a part of the British Army and if you started fighting against us, then you are responsible for treason. Somebody should ask these Britishers that when you lost in Singapore, actually what happened, friends, that a lot of Southeast Asian colonies, almost all the Southeast Asian colonies were under the British rule. Now when World War II started, then Japan was a part of the Axis powers. And Britain was a part of the Allied powers. So Axis versus Allied war was going on. And when Japan attacked British colonies in Southeast Asia, Japan actually occupied almost all the British colonies of Southeast Asia. Now there, all the Indian soldiers of Britain's army, they surrendered as prisoners of war. Those prisoners of war were being mobilized under Mohan Singh, and Indian National Army was formed. So a video, detailed video on Indian National Army I've already made, friends. So kindly go and watch that Indian National Army video. In that I told you the first Indian National Army, then the second Indian National Army. I also told you the role of Mohan Singh, Rash Bihari Bose, Subhash Chandra Bose, all of these roles in detail I have already discussed to you. So go there, friends, and watch that also. So actually there were a total of 10 court martials held during these Indian National Army trials. And the first court martial was the Red Fort trial, because actually it happened in Red Fort, Delhi. So that is why it was served as Red Fort trial. Now let's see what happened in the starting. In around 1945, friends, Rash Bihari Bose was dead, and also after the end of the Second World War, Subhash Chandra Bose was dead. Now a video, detailed video I have already made about Subhash Chandra Bose ji, his biography video, everything about his life I have discussed in detail in that video. So kindly go and watch that video. Its link is also given by me in the description box below. You can follow the link and go there and watch it. Now when Rash Bihari Bose, who was actually associated with Indian Independence League, and Subhash Chandra Bose, these are the main leaders, they were dead. Now the soldiers of the Indian National Army were leaderless. Okay. Second World War has almost ended. Japan and German forces have surrendered. So Indian National Army expeditions and march towards India has stopped. You know, Indian National Army did a lot of things. In association with the Japanese army, it took over the control of the Andaman and Nicobar Islands and renamed it as Shahid and Swaraj Islands. It also made a memorial. It also, you know, occupied the Moirang. It also occupied Burma. So a lot of these things were done by the Indian National Army. But actually when Japan lost, Japan forces surrendered. So Indian National Army, it also surrendered, because the background support to Indian National Army had not stopped. Now when this Indian National Army expedition stopped, the prisoners, the, you know, members of this Indian National Army, many were able to escape, friends. Many of them got mingled into the normal crowd. Many of them went to faraway places to find employment, and many of them were arrested. Around 16,000 were captured, friends, and they were sent to India. And actually, in order to accommodate these 16,000 men, detention camps were opened all over India where these 16,000 people were kept. Also, public trial court martial of the officers were held, and the first court martial, which was also known as the trial, Red Fort trial, it was of Colonel Prem Sahgal, Colonel Gurbaksh Singh Dhillon and Major General Shah Nawaz Khan. You can see one Colonel Prem Sahgal Hindu, Major General Shah Nawaz Khan Muslim, and Gurbaksh Singh Dhillon, he was Sikh. So actually it was a combined thing, and that is why you will see that Indian National Congress and Muslim League, you know, they cooperated to save all of these, you know, freedom fighters, friends. Also, as I've already told you that these Red Fort trials was a public trial, friends. Okay. Provision was made that obviously if trial is going on, then there will be arguments from two sides. One was the representative of British who said that, okay, these people are responsible for treason, and one were the representatives of these officers of the Indian National Army who said that, okay, these officers is right. So counsels were appointed. Now, this first public trial happened in Red Fort. When the second public trial will happen, friends, it will be moved from Red Fort to a nearby building. So actually, this defending these members of the Indian National Army was one thing on which Muslim League and Indian National Congress cooperated with each other. Indian National Congress and Muslim League, you know, their flags were flying together. Muslim League's green flag, Indian National Congress flag. So their flags, their all the support was combined to save these people. And this was, you can say, the last time when Indian National Congress and Muslim League cooperated on some issue. Okay, friends. Now, Indian National Army Defense Committee was organized by the Indian National Congress. And in this, one of the most famous lawyers and one of the most able lawyers of those times were deployed. They were Bhulabhai Desai, Asaf Ali, Jawaharlal Nehru, Tej Bahadur Sapru, and Kailash Nath Katju. So they were appointed to protect these people from the trial. So the trials started, and the trial covered a lot of arguments of international practices, constitutional law, international law, military law, politics. All of these things were being held in detail, discussed in detail. And in spite of the aggressive and widespread opposition of the court-martial of these three officers, we very well know the Britishers, friend, that the court-martial was carried out, and these three people were sentenced to deportation for life, which we also say as exile. Now, what is exile, friends? In exile, it happens that the sentenced person will be sent out of his country of origin at some other place, and he will be sent, he will be kept there for whole of his life. That is, for example, you know, in Bal Gangadhar Tilak was sent to jail in Mandalay, Burma for around 6 years. So he was sent outside country. So if anyone is sentenced for complete remaining life of his to some other place, which is not his country, place of birth or country of origin, so that will be sort of exile. And this was the deportation of life. This sentence was given to these three people. But the problem is that at this point of time, things have changed a lot. This was not the trial of Sukhdev, Bhagat Singh and Rajguru that they were hanged, friends. Here, the public opinion was very much in favor of these people, these Indian National Army soldiers. They were heroes in the eyes of Indian people. Lot of publicity of these trials was there. Public sympathy was totally in favor of these defendants because they were considered as the patriots. They fought for India, fought for the freedom of our country, and they were considered as patriots. So obviously people were hell-bent in protecting these people. Also, the biggest two parties of India, the Indian National Congress and Muslim League, they were cooperating to protect these people, friends. So obviously when this much amount of public support was present with these people, it became very difficult for the British administration to sentence them to any rigorous punishment, friends. So this was the thing. Also, friends, Second World War was over. All there was a government change in Great Britain, and Great Britain was of view that we should give independence to India as soon as possible. So when the Britishers were knowing that their time in India is limited, so when their rule in India is not fixed for a particular amount of time, how will they remain in a, how will they punish someone else? So actually, the public pressure, you know, pressurized Army Chief Field Marshal Claude Auchinlock to commute the sentences of the three defendants in the first trial only. And then the second trial happened, friends. And in all the subsequent trials, all the prisoners of war officers who were against whom the court-martial trial was going on, they all were set free after giving the benefits of army and after surrendering their salary. So, you know, putting minor restrictions upon them, they all were set free. In this case, the Britishers were not in the position to give any any sentence to them. Actually, they gave the sentence, but even after giving the sentence, the public pressure on the British administration was so high, friends. Also, the pressure from the Indian National Congress and Muslim League was so high that it was not up to the hands of British administration to punish these people for a long amount of time and giving them minor, punishment. They all were set free. So these were the Indian National Army trials, friends. Actually, I told you the most important things. I have not covered all the 10 court-martials. These were the 3-10 court-martials that I have covered, friends. And the name of the persons I have also covered. So you should remember that in your mind. I hope this video is clear to you, friends. If it is really good for you, kindly subscribe to my channel. Like this video. If you don't like this video, you can dislike it. But please tell me that why you didn't like this video. And please share this video more and more with your friends. So thank you for watching my video, friends. Have a great day. Goodbye.